Eh bien ici c'est la fille de D'Artagnan, Sophie Marceau.
Ah, ah, Sophie Marceau ici.
Hello, welcome in this new video, which is also another video for my series about the exhibition Fantaisie pour un palais. And in this video, we are visiting the castle. So that's something I did actually last week. After the press day, we went with all the journalists visiting all the castle, including the secret rooms no visitors are allowed to see. So it was really, really nice. But in this one, I thought the castle needed its own video because there are so many things to say and to share about it. So the first thing I can tell you, this castle has been used in a lot of productions and films throughout this past 20, 30, 40 years, including some very famous ones. And I plan actually next Christmas season, after holidays or after Christmas, when I'm a little less busy, I plan to rewatch some of these films just to see which room has been used for which scene. I think it's super fun to do that. So the first most famous one is Les Liaisons Dangereuses from, I think, 1988, something like that, which was partly filmed in this castle with the staircase, all that. There is a big part of Vatel, the film, which was filmed at the beginning of the century, and they still have all the costumes from Vatel. They did many exhibitions related to cinema. The film about Jean de La Fontaine, I mentioned this film in my little series last spring about La Fontaine, and the film has also been partly filmed in this castle. Many others, like Les Adieux à la Reine has been filmed there, La Fille de D'Artagnan, which is a French film, has been filmed there. A lot of period film, of course, and I think the series Versailles has also been partly filmed there.
Thank you.
So with the journalists, we were allowed to see all the secret places, mainly the attics, the secret rooms. There was the room of Lafayette that you know. He had a room for him in this castle. And there was a room for Voltaire, who was the French philosopher writer. He also had a room, so those are not super... They look like they had been like that for centuries. Probably not totally the case, but they don't let visitors in because maybe it's not very spectacular or anything like that. It's just moving to go in these sort of places. And we saw also the attics, all that. That was really, really nice just to see how it is in the attics of a castle like that.
Les musiciens étaient là. Mais oui, en plus, ça
pouvait pas être trop nombreux quand même.
Oui, alors là, on a la chambre
de Lafayette et la chambre de Voltaire.
Extraordinaire.
Mais en fait, ça vous donne une idée, parce que là, on est vraiment sur les tomettes d'époque, les escaliers, les boulevards, etc. Mais il y a des pièces partout, en fait.
Ouais, ouais.
Celles-ci sont à peu près visibles.
Ah, il fait plus frais, là, c'est marrant.
Oh là là.
Ouais. Je me souviens. Waouh!
Donc, ça, c'est. La fuite était assez proche de la chaise quand même.
Eh ben ici c'est la fille de D'Artagnan, Sophie Marceau, la chambre de Sophie Marceau.
Sophie Marceau ici.
Oui, c'est ça.
C'est maintenant que vous
voulez
le dire.
Ça
n'a
pas été évident
de
faire monter les équipes.
J'étais pas présente,
Et jusqu'à il y a très peu.
Juste comme ça, vous me disiez, il y en a.
Donc ça, ça bouge, je ne le
sais pas. Là, c'est ça en italienne.
Et là, voilà,
là, c'est
le... Regardez les détails
de la tapisserie. Elle est où la tapisserie? Ah, ici. Là, d'accord. Imaginaire, ouais. Enfin, linéaire en tout cas.
Oui. Oui, tu fais la marche.
Oui, j'imagine. Ouais. So what's so special about this castle? So it was built by François Mansart, and I made this mistake in my previous video, not the one about the exhibition, but the one before, because I said that it was the same architect who built Versailles, and it was not the same. Well, you know, there are so many who have the same name, it's just difficult. So it was his little nephew who took part of Versailles and not him. So if you can, just try to have a guided visit just to know and to discover all these little surprises of architecture, of things. So there are just a lot of beautiful improvements, architecture revolutions to discover in this castle. And on the staircase, it just left some squares under the staircase, some squares, which would let you know that at this place you should have had a pillar to support the staircase, and he didn't need it because he created his staircase with walls, so it was pretty nice. There are so many castles in the Parisian era, in all these parts of France actually. Parisians are really spoiled children, they don't see the beauty around them as they should for most of them. And they have so many castles, so many places. They're just really, really spoiled children, and they don't go to visit everything. And the tourists, they often don't go out of Paris, and it's just close, it's just very close. But they just stay, they do the same three things all the tourists do, like the Eiffel Tower and all these things. And they never see these places, which is really sad because they are just as nice as the others. They're just a little further. You need to take the Parisian train, which is the RER, RERA, to go there, which is super easy to do. You can take that in the center of Paris, and then you arrive, and it's 25-30 minutes maximum, so it's not a long time, and then by foot it's 10 minutes. It's really, really easy in public transport to get there, but yes, tourists are, they do their tourist things, and Parisians are a bit lazy. I said to a few persons I knew who live in Paris that, well, there was this beautiful exhibition that they should see, in this castle, and they told me that, wow, it's really far. And this really far thing is a bit a caricature that a Parisian would say. Everything is far for them. They just, everything has to be exactly where they are, or they don't go, they don't move. And French are a bit like that already. I experienced that in the past with my workshop. I told you a lot about that. That's the reason I stopped at some point, because French don't move easily compared to other countries when people are used to do kilometers to go somewhere. Here it's not the case. People, especially for entertaining things. For work it's different, but for their leisure and their fun and all that, they wouldn't do that the same way. So it's really sad, and I hope if you come to Paris that you don't do all the same thing every tourist do, because it's crowded, by the way. But as I said, if you go a little in some specific places, you have the best time of the world. People in this place were super friendly everywhere. In the bakery, in my hotel, they were super nice everywhere. You don't have that in Paris most of the time, in the center. In the touristic places, people are not nice. That's the truth. You experience that all the time. But there, they were really, really friendly. So just something interesting to know. And I was there the afternoon after the journalist left. I went back there after lunch last week, and I had the castle for myself, totally for myself. It was magical to be in this beautiful castle pretty much on my own. There were just few persons, few visitors. Now, of course, that there is the exhibition, there will be a bit more people, especially during the festive season, during weekends, for holidays, things like that. But it's still a great experience to go there. You don't have to do a line for 5 hours. You just enjoy it completely. You can see everything. It's pretty nice. Thank you very much for watching this visit. I hope it inspired you maybe to come to visit. Even if you come later and the exhibition is not there anymore, you can still enjoy the castle, which is really worth seeing. And it's just a perfect place to go if you don't like crowded place like me. So I have just below the link to the blog post on my blog with all the information, details, the hotel I slept in, the transport you need to use when you come from Paris Center, all that. So all these informations are on my blog, and it's very easy to go, no worries. It's less far than Versailles actually, so you will have no problem to go and to enjoy it properly. And if you come when the days are a bit better, when it's sunny, you can enjoy the park. I couldn't do it because it was really raining and snowing, so it was not possible for me to do that really well, but next time I hope I will enjoy it a bit better. Hope you liked the visit. Well, give a thumbs up if you liked it. Just subscribe if you don't want to miss all the next videos. I have a lot of super nice things coming. The Rococo Hall is coming, just to show you a lot of things around the exhibition and this era that could inspire you. And a bit later, I have the video at my friend's house. I filmed it already. It's editing that right now, so you're going to see that soon. And all my Christmas series, of course, and the new Christmas workshop, which is coming in December 10. So hope to see you very soon, and for now I will leave you here.